Hello friends, if you like my videos, subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you. So students, in this video we are going to discuss about isosporiasis, right? So in this video I'm going to explain to you about the morphology of Isospora belli and the symptoms and even the life cycle which will be exhibited by this Isospora belli which causes isosporiasis, right? So firstly let us discuss about the introduction of isosporiasis. So the other name of isosporiasis is cystoisosporiasis, and it is a human intestinal disease where the disease occurs in the human intestine, in the epithelial cells of the human intestine, right? So the life cycle of this Isospora belli will also be exhibited in the epithelial cells only, right? So normally the cystoisosporiasis is mainly caused by a parasite, by a protozoan parasite called as Isospora belli, and the other name of this Isospora belli is Cystoisospora belli, right? So Cystoisospora belli or Isospora belli, both are same, okay? And even the isosporiasis and cystoisosporiasis are both are same, okay? So this is just the introduction which I wanted to give you about the isosporiasis, and it is found worldwide except tropical and subtropical regions, and it can be passed from one person to another person through contaminated food and water, right? So normally this isosporiasis was the first case of a person who is infected with this isosporiasis was filed on 1915, right? So now let us learn about the morphology of Isospora belli. As if you see in the structure here, this is the oocyst of Isospora belli. So normally this oocyst, I mean here which I have drawn, is a mature oocyst. So what is the difference between immature oocyst and mature oocyst? See, in immature oocyst, the sporozoids will not get completely developed. But in the case of mature oocyst, here the sporozoids will be completely developed, right? So here which I have drawn, the diagram which I have drawn is mature oocyst of Isospora belli. So if you see here, this is the oocyst, and inside the oocyst there will be two sporocysts. So this green color one which I have drawn are nothing but the sporocysts. So there are two sporocysts, and in each sporocyst, four sporozoids will be present. So as I have drawn with red color, these are called as sporozoids. So these two are sporocysts, and each sporocyst, four sporozoids will be present, and this will be another sporocyst where it contains another four sporozoids. So totally eight sporozoids will be present in a single oocyst, right? And coming to the length of this oocyst, the length ranges from 20 to 23 micrometers in length, okay? And it is spindle shaped body where the structure is long. And coming to the wideness, it ranges from 10 to 19 micrometers. So what is the length? 20 to 23 micrometers, and the wide is 10 to 19 micrometers. So this will be the morphology of oocyst of Isospora belli. So now let us see the life cycle which will be exhibited by Isospora belli to cause the disease called as isosporiasis, right? So now let us discuss about the life cycle of Isospora belli. So if you see here, normally the life cycle will start from the human being, and here in this case the human being is affected with this disease. So what is the disease called as isosporiasis? Let us say this is a person who is infected with the isosporiasis disease. So now we know that man will excrete fecus material, right? So once the fecus material will be excreted from its body, then what will happen? Then the oocyst will also be released because the person has been infected with isosporiasis, right? Such that the oocyst will be released along with the fecus material. And don't forget to remember, this oocyst belong to Isospora belli, right? Because the person is infected with isosporiasis, fine? So now this oocyst will be released along with the fecus material, right? And here the oocyst which has been released is immature in form. So I have said you what is the difference between immature and mature. It is said to be as immature oocyst. Why? Because the sporozoids are not completely developed, right? So now what will happen? Now this oocyst will undergo the maturation process in such a way that in the first stage, what will happen? You know, immature oocyst with sporoblasts will be developed, right? Sporoblasts will be developed. And in the next stage, what will happen? Again, the immature oocyst will only be developed, but here the sporocysts will be formed. So here there are two sporocysts, right? Which I have said you in the morphology, in these green color circles which I have drawn inside this cytoplasm of this oocyst are called as sporocyst, right? And now after the maturation process, again what will happen? This red color one which I have drawn inside are called as sporozoids, which will get developed in the mature oocyst by the process called as maturation, right? So what will happen? The sporocyst will be completely developed and which contains the sporozoids. Hence, you are going to name this as a mature oocyst. So why it is named as mature oocyst? Because here the sporozoids are well developed. As I have said you, each sporocyst contains 4 sporozoids, right? So this sporocyst contains 4 sporozoids and this sporocyst contains 4 sporozoids, right? So it is called as mature oocyst. So why it is called as immature oocyst? Because here the sporozoids are not developed yet, right? And now what will happen? Again, this mature oocyst will enter into the human body digestive system. So how? Through contaminated food and water. By consuming contaminated food and water, then what will happen? Then the oocyst will enter into the digestive system. It will be taken by the human beings, right? Then it will enter into the digestive system of the human beings. So now what will happen in the digestive system? This is the main important thing which you people have to remember. So as I have said you, this isosporiasis is a human intestinal disease. So why it is called as human intestinal disease? Let us see now. Because major part of the life cycle occurs in the isosporiasis occurs in the human digestive system only. So what is that life cycle? Let us see now. So now our digestive system contains epithelial cells, right? So let us assume these are the epithelial cells which I have drawn. All of these boxes which I have drawn are nothing but the epithelial cells. Okay, all of these are epithelial cells. Now what will happen? Now the mature oocyst which contain the sporozoids will enter into the digestive system of human beings through contaminated food and water, which I have said you before. Now what will happen? Now it enters near to the epithelial cells, not into the epithelial cells. It will enter near to the epithelial cells and attaches to the surface of the epithelial cells. And now what it will do? Now what will happen, you know, the cyst wall will get ruptured. Here this is the oocyst, right? Once it enter into the digestive system near the epithelial cells, then the cyst wall will get ruptured. Along with the cyst wall, the sporocyst wall will also get ruptured. So this is the sporocyst wall, right? It will also get ruptured. We know that each sporocyst contains 4 sporozoids. So all of these are nothing but the sporozoids, right? So this is the sporocyst, and inside the sporocyst, sporozoids are present, and that sporozoids will get protruded out. It will get released, and those sporozoids will enter into the epithelial cells. Now these sporozoids, which has been released by the rupturing of sporocyst, will enter into the epithelial cells of human digestive system, right? So now here the actual process begins. So now what will happen? These are the sporozoids which has been entered into the epithelial cells by the rupturing of this oocyst, right? And now this will undergo asexual reproduction process. So what is it? What is the process called as zygogony? So it undergoes the process of zygogony through asexual reproduction process, and then it will get completely developed into a zygote. And now inside the zygote, merozoids will be present. And once the zygote will get ruptured, then the merozoids which are present inside the zygotes will be released, right? So all of this, the blue color which I have drawn, are nothing but the merozoids, and all of these merozoids will get released out by the rupturing of the zygote, right? And now these merozoids will get developed into microgametes as well as the macrogametes. So these are nothing but the microgametes and these are macrogametes, right? So as we all of us know that these microgametes are considered as male individuals, right? And these macrogametes are considered as female individuals, right? So what will happen here? The male individuals as well as the female individuals will get developed from these merozoids, right? So now what will happen? So now the fertilization of microgametes and macrogametes will be done. So as if you see here, which I have mentioned here, so this is a macrogamete and this is a microgamete. The fertilization of microgamete and macrogamete will be done, and that process is called as sexual reproduction, right? Here the sexual reproduction will be done because the fertilization is a process which has been going on by using microgametes as well as the macrogametes. And now after the fertilization, then what will happen? Then the zygote will be formed. And what is that zygote? It is nothing but the immature oocyst. It is not mature. It is immature oocyst. So why I am going to call it as an immature oocyst? Because the sporozoids are not present over here. And now what will happen? And this immature oocyst will be released out from the human being through fecus material. And once they are released through fecus material, then again the total life cycle will get repeated. So in the human digestive system, in the epithelial cells of the human digestive system, the asexual reproduction process as well as the sexual reproduction process will be done such that the immature oocyst will be developed from the sporozoids which has been released by the rupturing of oocyst. And then the process will be going on, and then the immature oocyst will be developed in the epithelial cell itself. Then what will happen? Then the fecus material will be released by that particular human being who is infected, and then the fecus material contains oocyst, and now again the total life cycle will get repeated, where this immature oocyst will get completely developed into mature oocyst, right? It will get completely developed into mature oocyst, and again the total life cycle will get repeated. So if you see here, the major part of the life cycle will be done in the epithelial cells itself. Hence, this cystoisosporiasis is considered as human intestinal disease, right? And now let us discuss about the symptoms which can be seen in the person who is infected with isosporiasis or cystoisosporiasis. So to know about the symptoms: abdominal pain, cramps, loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, fever. So all of these are the minor symptoms which you can see in a person who is infected with this disease called as isosporiasis. But extreme diarrhea is a most common disease which can be seen in the isosporiasis affected person, right? So this is about isosporiasis, which is also called as cystoisosporiasis. And if you like my explanation, you can like and subscribe my channel. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, you can comment in the comment box. We are going to clarify your doubts immediately. But don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.